The series circuit consists of a power supply and a minimum of two consumers, in our case two resistors. The first thing we can notice is that the same current flows through both resistors. To calculate this current, we use Ohm's law. But Ohm's law mentions only one resistor. Well, we will calculate one common resistor for the whole series circuit. Series circuit can be seen as a necklace. Each part of the necklace, although different, is connected to its neighbor in a row. The total weight of the necklace is the sum of all its individual parts. Thus, we can present our circuit as just one resistor that will represent the sum of resistors R1 and R2. In case there are several resistors in series, we just simply add them up and get the total resistance of the series circuit, as shown by the official equation. Now that we know the total resistance, we use Ohm's law to calculate the current of the series circuit. If you don't know how Ohm's law works, watch my video about it first. The link is in the video description. Now that we know the current of the series circuit, it remains to calculate only the voltages V1 and V2. You can always easily check that you have calculated everything well, because in the end you add up the individual voltages on the resistors, in our case V1 and V2, and you get the amount of supply voltage. Now that we know all the equations, let's check how it works in practice. In the first example, we will use real values. So, the supply voltage and resistor values are known, and we need to calculate the current and voltages V1 and V2. We first calculate the total resistance. Then the current, and the voltages V1 and V2. Finally, we check whether the sum of voltages V1 and V2 is equal to the supply voltage. If so, we calculated everything correctly. In the second example, we have a case that engineers encounter on a daily basis. For example, if you have a device that does not have a signal lamp when it is turned on, or if a new PCB is being designed and we want to have it, then pay attention to how it is done properly. Basic parameters of electronic components are available from the manufacturer. This is how we come to the initial values. For example, our diode has an operating voltage of 3 volts and a maximum current of 2 milliamperes. Suppose our device uses a voltage of 24 volts. Then we have to calculate the resistor to limit the current through the series circuit to 2 milliamperes. Also, we need to provide 3 volts for the diode to work properly. This means that the rest of the voltage must remain on the resistor. You have probably noticed that the diode current is actually the current through the whole circuit. We use now known values and confirm that all the remaining voltage is on the resistor. And we come to the most important part of this task, and that is calculating the value of the resistor. Why the most important? Well, because it depends on the resistor whether everything will work properly. Using Ohm's law, we calculate the value of the resistor 10.5 kilo ohms, and this is the value below which we must not go. With this value, the maximum diode load as well as the maximum brightness is achieved. For safety reasons, it is better to round this value to 11 kilo ohms. If we want to reduce the light intensity, we simply choose a resistor of a higher value according to our own wishes, while still providing a minimum current through the diode. The minimum current information is also provided by the diode manufacturer. So, from 11 kilo ohms upwards is allowed, but not less, because it can damage the LED. Well, we've come to the end of this video. If you like this old school way of explaining, subscribe, like, comment, suggest, and expect more interesting videos soon. Thanks for watching, and see you.